have the lights and light up the tree. We're damned for all eternity, but for just one day, all is well. It's Christmas time in hell.
Heather Autumn, and welcome to my channel. All right, so this is my first video post-op, and also it's the holiday weekend, and so I just want to say hi, happy holidays. I hope you're having fun and not stuck outside in this horrendous storm that we're gonna be having. So yeah, I just went for my first post-op appointment, and everything's healing up really well. You can kind of see it. I don't know, this is my first time filming with it. I'm just not gonna hide it because it's gonna get lighter over time, and I just don't wanna make the effort of hiding something that I'm actually kind of proud about. So, but everything has been going really well. Things have been healing up just fine, and I have some stretches to do on this arm. It's a little numb. They did have to cut through some like nerves, and so I'm not sure if the numbness is here to stay or not, but given what was there prior, it's fine. Okay, so for today's holiday themed recipe, I'm gonna show you how to make an eggnog espresso martini. And it's made with either rum, bourbon, or vodka. And I happen to be low on vodka and rum, so I have bourbon, and that's what I'm gonna be using, but feel free to substitute the bourbon with something else if you wish. So if you like this recipe but you want it written out, you can always go to the description below and it'll link you to my blog, which I will have this all written out step by step and all the ingredients and everything. And you can just go there to check out what you need for this recipe. Okay, so for this recipe, it's pretty straightforward. It's a martini. So you will need a martini glass, and then you're gonna need spiced rum, which I would recommend Kraken or vodka, or today what we're gonna be using is just a straight bourbon. You'll also be needing Kahlua, which is that. So the next thing you're gonna need is either espresso or cold brew. And I actually happen to get this, which is a Starbucks cold brew right there. Looks pretty good. Then you'll need some eggnog. I'm not a huge fan of eggnog, and I only need a little of this, but this was the only eggnog I could find. So if you can find the single serving bottles, that would be perfect for this recipe. Or if you have some leftover eggnog and you just don't know what to do with it, now's the time to use it. Next, you want some pure vanilla extract. I have this one here. The recipe calls for a pinch of salt, if you have it, and also some ground nutmeg or some ground cinnamon, depending on what your flavor is. Other special ingredients would include a shaker. I got this one on Amazon. I love it. Next up is a strainer, because you're gonna fill it with ice and you don't want the ice going into the martini glass. So I have a strainer. Usually these are sold in sets. It's just a bar set, and they can range anywhere from like 24 bucks to really expensive and nice ones. I have a mid-range one for here at home, and it has kind of everything I need, and it's not so flimsy that it's gonna break, but not so expensive I'm breaking the bank. The other thing you're gonna need is one of these. This is called a jigger, and the top part is 1.5 ounces, and this little bottom part is 1 ounce, and this is what you'll use to measure all of your ingredients. Okay, so first and foremost, you're gonna fill your shaker with some ice, and then you're gonna go and start adding in all of your other ingredients. All right, first up is our bourbon. We will need 1 ounce of that. Next up is our Kahlua, and we're going to need 1 ounce of that. Next is our espresso or cold brew, and we will need 1 ounce of that. Next, you're gonna need 3 to 4 ounces of eggnog, so we're gonna use 2 of these for 3. Next, next, you're going to need this vanilla extract, and you're going to use 1/4 teaspoon. Pinch of salt. And my personal favorite is cinnamon, so I'm going to use a dash of that. So once you've got all of your ingredients assembled, what you're gonna do is brace the top and shake it for anywhere from like 15 to 30 seconds, just to make sure it's really nice and frothy. So mine has a built-in strainer here, so I don't have to use one. Alright, so there it is. I like to garnish mine with a little bit of cinnamon, and let's give it a try. I will never have eggnog the same way again. The dangerous part about this drink is that you really can't taste the alcohol. It just, and actually, even if you didn't like eggnog, it's like it all offsets all the bad points of eggnog or mixed drinks having too much alcohol in them where it like kind of is astringent. That's canceled out with this drink. It's really just a sweet, creamy, kind of cinnamony, cold drink. It's great. I really like it. Sometimes I make mixed drinks and I'm not a fan of them. And there's times where I have to scrap an entire episode because I'm like, I'm not gonna lie and be like, oh my God, it's great, when it was horrible. But this was an amazing drink. I'm so happy I have it, and I'm so happy I have more ingredients to make it later, because definitely in my like top 10 of festive drinks to make. This is a great drink if you have spent all night getting presents ready and you just want to sit down and relax and just have an adult drink. This is fabulous. So I know that this episode was really short, and I'm sorry about that, but thank you so much for watching. This has been a fantastic year, and YouTube and this channel has really just changed my life and helped me to focus on tons of fun things, and getting your feedback and comments and just support has been amazing this year, and I'm so grateful. That's one of those big gifts that I feel like you guys have given me, which is just helping me to know that I'm on the right track with this. I'm currently making my editorial calendar for next year, which is full of just trips and recipes. I'm kind of trying to split it 50-50 because I've had some people say I really love cooking content and others say I really love your travel stuff. So I want to focus on just both of those and alternating weekends, and I'm just really excited and looking forward to it. So again, thank you. If you have been a supporter of this channel, I just really appreciate it. And if this is the first time you have visited my channel, first of all, welcome. And if you would like to see more episodes, or if you'd like to see what the next year has, please be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. It helps my channel. It lets YouTube know that my content is being watched and liked. And also, if you hit the subscribe button, it sends out a little notification to you saying, hey, I have a new episode out, so you'll never miss one. So again, thank you from my home to yours. Happy holidays. All right, thank you, and I'll see you later. Bye.